You're watching Next Tech Insider, where we're looking to banter and engage with some of the most eclectic and inspiring thought leaders in the innovation space whose work could redefine reality as we know it. Today, I'm chatting to Kourosh Atefipour, the fascinating co-founder of a startup that I really am keeping my eyes firmly on, Valkyrie. Right, Kourosh, thank you for being here.
Thank you for having me.
Talk to us about what Valkyrie is all about.
Sure, so Valkyrie is building a wearable tool that lets you touch and feel objects much more naturally in virtual simulations, such as VR, augmented reality, all the paradigms where you can actually be more immersed in virtual worlds.
Right, and I've been fascinated with touch reality and being able to infuse the sense of feeling and simulating the actual kind of touch of digital objects in your virtual environment for years now. So paint for me a kind of a picture of some of the fascinating use cases where incorporating touch into a virtual environment could mean the difference between understanding a concept and really understanding what it means and actually experiencing it in a sort of tactile way.
So one of the really big visions that we have is a doctor, a resident in residency, in training, being able to practice with patients time and time again without, you know, any risks or liability issues. Another great example is unbuilt wind farms or offshore oil and gas sea rigs, where you have employees, you need to train them, perhaps the site's not built yet.
Right.
And then when you add the ability for people to actually start seeing their fingers, being able to pick up objects, do tasks, they can start doing their jobs a lot more quicker.
Let's just do some context setting, right? What is mixed reality? Is that the same as crossover reality where you've got VR plus AR plus touch? Or is it just one end of the spectrum? Define that for our viewers.
Right, so mixed reality is this paradigm where you have one end of the spectrum, augmented reality, where you have virtual assets overlaid in the real world. And then you have the virtual reality sort of aspect of it, which puts in all the virtual assets and really immerses you with all your senses, all your perception, all the proprioception that you have within, to actually being in a world that might not necessarily happen. Touch is the third level immersion that we're personally bringing to these worlds. It doesn't necessarily define the mixed reality, but it is more or less sort of immersive tech that we're personally bringing towards these platforms.
So sort of next-gen immersion.
Exactly, yeah.
So I suppose what I want to understand, Kourosh, is a lot of our viewers will come to us with questions such as, this sounds fantastic, where can I get one? Now, obviously, at the moment, this is a nascent stage in terms of it's not in our households yet. How far away are we from that? And I'm not expecting a specific prediction, but it's a rough idea of, will this ever make it to our homes?
So touch technology does have a couple of hurdles to go through before it comes into home use. There's a lot of kind of jargon, there's a lot of money that you have to spend on different parts. How do I know which components I'm going to need to buy in my computer? Do I even have the right computer or the specifications?
Exactly.
They go on and on. And that's what scares the consumer when it comes to virtual and augmented reality. So I very much would like to see a future where you don't need the big expensive computers, you don't have this limitation of the wire, I don't need a 4x4 room set up where I can only access that space. But instead, you take virtual augmented, you put it under this mixed reality paradigm, where I can walk out into the street, I'm not bound by any machines, I don't have any wires. It's the maximum sort of performance that I can get from this product that I've paid a lot of money for, but when I walk outside, I can have the best of both worlds.
I think a lot of questions here, and you've answered them beautifully, so
thank you so much
for being with us on Next Tech Insider, Kourosh. And thank you for watching.